फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। फॉर द रीजन्स स्टेटेड इन द एप्लीकेशन द सेम इज अलाउड एंड द मेन केस इज टेकन अप टूडे फॉर हियरिंग। द पेटिशनर्स हैव प्रेड फॉर कॉसिंग ऑफ FIR नंबर 131 फॉर ऑफेंस पनिशेबल अंडर सेक्शन 323 रीड विद सेक्शन 149 ऑफ द इंडियन पेनल कोड 1860 एट पुलिस स्टेशन डिवीजन डिस्ट्रिक्ट अमृतसर एंड ऑल अदर कॉन्सिक्वेंशियल प्रोसीडिंग्स अराइजिंग देयर फ्रॉम ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द कंप्रोमाइज इफेक्टेड बिटवीन द पार्टीज। वाइड आर्डर डेटेड 24 February 2021 द पार्टीज वर डायरेक्टेड टू अपीयर बिफोर द ट्रायल कोर्ट मजिस्ट्रेट टू गेट दियर स्टेटमेंट्स रिकॉर्डेड विद रिगार्ड टू जूनियननेस ऑफ द कंप्रोमाइज। अ रिपोर्ट डेटेड 2 March 2021 हैज़ बीन सबमिटेड बाय द जुडिशियल मजिस्ट्रेट फर्स्ट क्लास अमृतसर वेयर इन इट हैज़ बीन रिपोर्टेड दैट स्टेटमेंट्स ऑफ द पेटिशनर्स एंड रेस्पोंडेंट नंबर 2 and 3 हैव बीन रिकॉर्डेड एंड स्टेटमेंट्स मेड बाय द पार्टीज इन द कोर्ट रिवील दैट दे हैव वॉलंटरली एंटर्ड इनटू अ कंप्रोमाइज एंड द कोर्ट इज सेटिस्फाइड दैट द पार्टीज हैव एमिकेबली सेटल्ड दियर डिस्प्यूट विदाउट एनी फियर प्रेशर थ्रीट आर कोर्सन एंड आउट ऑफ दियर फ्री विल। Counsel for the petitioners has submitted that no other criminal case is pending between the parties and none of the petitioner has been declared as proclaimed offender. Counsel for the state assisted with counsel for the respondent number 2 and 3 has not disputed the fact that the parties have arrived at a settlement with an intent to give burial to their differences. Sir, I do suggest that every municipality in this country should maintain a register of the unemployed. Of course, we have now the labor exchanges. Unfortunately, they are not to be found everywhere and all unemployed do not register themselves there. Therefore, I suggested that in every municipality there should be an unemployment register and propaganda should be done among the unemployed that they should first register themselves in the municipal register. Similarly, I would suggest that in every village panchayat there should be a register where people will register themselves for underemployment because during the harvest season there is actually shortage of labor in the villages rather than the reverse. Therefore, there would have to be different kinds of registers to show in what seasons you want to give employment and to devise suitable employment. First of all, this is not a single problem but two different and distinct problems. We should not confuse total unemployment with partial employment or underemployment. It is for me a great pleasure to associate myself with the formal opening of the Indian Institute of Technology at Kharagpur. When I assumed charge of the Ministry of Education in 1947, I felt that of the many tasks of educational reconstruction that faced the country to were of paramount urgency. The first was the creation of a nationwide system of basic education for all children of school going age and the second the provisions of facilities of the highest type of education in the technical field. You are aware that the prevailing system of education in the country has been mainly literary and academic. It has not supplied us with the high-level scientific and technical पर्सनल दैट इज नेसेसरी टू डेवलप आवर इकोनॉमिक एंड मटेरियल रिसोर्सेज एंड इम्प्रूव द स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ लाइफ ऑफ आवर पीपल. फॉर सच एजुकेशन वी हैव हैड टू सेंड आवर स्टूडेंट्स अब्रोड एंड फ्राम वेरियस पॉइंट्स ऑफ व्यू दिस हैज नेवर बीन एंड कैन नॉट बी फुल्ली सेटिस्फैक्ट्री. One of the first decisions I took on assuming charge was that we must so improve the facilities for higher technical education in the country that we could ourselves meet most of our needs. What we see functioning here is the distortion of development from planned targets under the influence of the pressure from parents and pupils in the upper strata who everywhere are politically powerful. Even more remarkable is the fact that this tendency to distortion from the point of view of the planning objectives is more accentuated in the poorest countries, Pakistan, India, Burma, and Indonesia, which started out with far fewer children in primary schools and which should therefore have the strongest reasons to carry out the program of giving primary schooling the highest priority. It is generally the poorest countries that are spending least, even relatively, on primary education and that are permitting the targets distortions from the planned targets in favor of secondary and tertiary education. In his other book Challenge of World Poverty, published in 1970, he discusses elaborately in chapter 6 Education, the reasons for and the consequences of neglect of basic education in this country. He quotes still considered to be the most authoritative study of education since in India as saying educational development is benefiting the haves more. This is a negation of social justice and planning proper, and our constitution speaks repeatedly of social justice preamble and article 38. Though this is the best occasion on which I have in person attended a session of UNESCO, I may claim that in spirit I have always been with you and followed your deliberations and activities with the keenest interest and sympathy. This I have done as I feel that in view of the disaster which threatens the future of mankind, UNESCO alone offers a faint ray of hope. Mankind has in the course of the last century made phenomenal advances in knowledge and material prosperity, but this progress has not been reflected in man's moral and political achievement. Increased knowledge has therefore led not only to a greater provision for comforts and victory over want and disease, but also, alas, to an increase in man's power for destruction and death. This power is so great today that unless all men have a sense of community, it may well lead to common ruin for all. It is only through a re-education of man that we can create that sense of psychological unity and common citizenship which the technological unity achieved by the advance of modern science requires of man. This is the reason why in 1949, when the Indian National Commission for Cooperation with UNESCO was founded, I placed such great emphasis on the importance of UNESCO's work. I pointed out with regret that while the United Nations were founded for the achievement of peace and unity, the result had इन फैक्ट बीन द डिवीजन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इनटू टू वार्निंग कैंप्स इट इज़ ट्रू दैट सम प्रोग्रेस हैज बीन अचीव्ड हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ अ मल्टीट्यूड ऑफ नेशंस Each struggling on its own, the United Nations present a picture of two solid blocks, array one against the other.